If you're looking for a Notion template that can take your business and personal life to the next level, you're in the right place. So the Evergreen Notion Workspace is an advanced Notion template that I created in order to help you prioritize your life and set your life up in a way where no matter what you want to get done, you will have the answer to that question at all times. So if we go right here into this forest section in the TTP Hub and Evergreen Notion Workspace, you can see that this is my alignment. Work is at the top of my alignment regarding task priority, followed by rise productive, and then the growth that I want to have in my life, and then just basic life tasks. The way that this is set up is, first and foremost, you have your different life trees. So for me, I think this is a perfect example of somebody who wants to have a growth mindset in my age group, or just in the age group of someone that's more single and not quite as family oriented at this point. I am somebody who wants to grow my career and side hustle more than anything, as well as my personal development. And then last but not least, housekeeping tasks. I plan on having that maybe change in the future, but the way that this is set up is essentially you put in your alignment to what you want to have regarding the different time management that you'll have. So for me, I have a bunch of different time breakouts that I did. I figured out how much time I would spend on different things throughout the week. And I figured out the commitment time. And this is an equation where it takes the baseline of the 168 hours in a week. And then what you can do is subtract the different amount of time from your commitments. So I have 40 hours a week on work, 56 on sleep, 16 on family, and then there's about 15 hours on predictable time. This is something that changes per person, as if you are somebody who lives alone or doesn't have help with like doing different housekeeping tasks, your unpredictable time for somebody who has multiple kids is probably more than the 25 hours a week, 30 hours a week. I'm only at 15. And then also you'll have commitments that aren't like what mine are. But this is my current breakout where I have 41 hours about of discretionary time a week, and I try to put it as much as I can towards what I want. So this is what I have in my alignment. And then based on this, this input that I have in here with the time goals that I have, then go into this forest, which showcase this different task priority. So first and foremost, obviously the highest amount of time I'm supposed to be spending on things is work. So then when we move forward with that, we know that there are different things inside of each life tree, and those life trees have branches. So as you can see here, there is a very simple breakout of what I end up doing at Rise Productive. So first and foremost, content drives this place forward. My YouTube channel, I post all the time. And then followed by that is sales funnels. And then after that, we have the growth that I want to have in my life. And first and foremost, I view that as health and fitness, then mental clarity, then knowledge. And then below that is just life stuff, like life admin. I got to pay my credit card bill. I got to pay my car off. I have different housekeeping tasks that I need to do, like cleaning. And then last but not least on this list is social. But with the TTP method, it's time, trees, and priorities. So first and foremost, the time aspect means that if somebody wants to reach out to me to hang out, time is a thing, time is linear. So I would prioritize the task of making the time with the person. For example, Chance, my co-host on the Rise Productive podcast, I asked him yesterday, hey, do you want to hang out this weekend? Because while the amount of time that I had in my block schedule may not have been catered towards hanging out with people on Sundays, I made the time because he's my friend and I want to go hang out with him. And moving forward in this workspace, you have this basic alignment, and it makes sense that this task priority exists, but in real time, we can see how this functions. So this is the overall section and the TTP Hub homepage. You can see the different trees laid out here with the different parts of the branches laid out here as well. And each of these trees has a really nice setup where you have the branches put here, and then you have roots, resources, and projects. So currently there's not a whole lot going on, so this is filtered so that it's like in progress. But the nice part about this template is it actually has everything in a drop-down toggle so that you can pull whatever roots that you want or resources. Now a root is essentially like an area of responsibility from the PARA method, but tweaked a little bit so it's a continuous project database. Like my YouTube master content calendar is in a database that I don't plan on ending, whereas a project is something that probably is going to have an end. For example, if you're applying to different scholarships, that's a project because you're not going to be in school forever, but you are probably going to have a long-term investment regarding a roots when it comes to things like your content, or for sales funnels, templates, and then something like writing ebooks and stuff. You should probably keep trying to grow that. That's the similar thing that a business would have when it's like the marketing department would obviously have a content calendar, and the accounting department would obviously have a continuous tracking of finances, but you probably would have a specific project to try to like revamp a website maybe for the marketing team. And then resources are reference material that then help you organize your data. So I have different process docs that help Chance kind of get onboarded onto different tests in Rise Productive, as well as new people will add to the team eventually. So the way that this is sorted is it starts with time. So whatever is first in order of time shows up at the top, and then it goes to the tree priority. So as you saw, whatever's the highest priority. So if it is two Rise Productive tasks, after the time has been figured out, then it's like, well, what do I figure out regarding the order there? That would be the branch priority. So I think content's more important than sales funnels. So that gets catered to first, and then root would be, you know, is it a YouTube task? YouTube's more important to me than my podcast. In essence, the same with the newsletter. YouTube is like the main driving content channel, so that would go on top. But I have a time blocking method so that I factor in when I'm going to do these things. But if all that goes to the wayside, then this shows me outside of this one where the time isn't showcased right, because essentially in Notion, if it doesn't have an include time associated to it, it doesn't show it. But if I get rid of this guy, the YouTube edits goes on the top because content's more important to me than sales funnels. And this template is built out with an insane amount of work put into it. As you can see, there's a weekly view where you can have it filtered out so that if I check this off, it'll disappear or not. This can be like an overview where it shows everything that's been checked off. There's a indify.co widget where you can replace it with your own. And this is a recurring task framework that you can make here. As you'll see at the bottom, I have an entire task framework made for myself. And then you can reference this task framework and make recurring tasks for yourself, in the sense where it'll basically just be templated buttons so that you can create new ones here. So if I made a new one here for myself and dragged it to this day, you can see that's at 5 a.m. That's when I planned on doing it. And that's an easy way to do recurring tasks that I've showcased before. And this page is where you could also take different things from your capture inbox, like different tasks that I want to put into my workflow. And on days where I plan my weeks, I can drop these things quickly into different days of the week to make it happen. Now, lastly, I will say this. I have talked about a review section that I've utilized in the Evergreen Notion workspace. And this is really cool. It implements stacking relations, where this is basically a bunch of different relations put together. So this is an example review of a month, but in the weeks that associate to it, you can see there was a data input for how much time I spent on it, and it all aggregates into a month. There's a more in-depth review of this workspace if you go to riseproductive.com/evergreen. I'd go check that out, and also go check out this video if you want to see how you can improve your Notion even more. You'll like it. It's a good one.